welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are having an awesome day and thank you guys so much for joining me. Today I want to share with you guys my favorites for the year of 2014. This was really hard and I have a ton of crap to show you. I'm going to start with skincare, and the first two things should be like of no surprise to you guys. The first thing is Purity, and this is my all-time forever favorite facial cleanser. It is amazing. It is very gentle on the skin. It really deeply cleanses and it smells amazing. And honestly, it is the best facial cleanser ever. It's not. These two products are from Milani, and this is the Brow Shaping Clear Wax. And this just does a really good job of kind of like priming your eyebrows, especially when you're gonna put powders and stuff to like fill them in. I feel like this really gives the powder something to hold on to, and it really does like kind of control the unruliness of the eyebrows, so this is really good. And then I really love this brow gel, and it's just like a little clear brow gel with a little wand. Next, I'm going to talk to you guys about primers. Hourglass Mineral Veil Primer. I've gone through a few samples and I've opened up like an actual larger travel size one. I love this so much. I feel like it does such an awesome job at prepping your skin for the foundation, at helping this like the makeup just lay on your face beautifully, especially if you are someone like me who has very oily skin. I feel like this is a great primer, and everyone should try it. And then for foundations, one of my all-time favorite foundations for years, I don't even know how many years I've had this I've kept purchasing this foundation. It's my L'Oreal True Match. This is just the regular True Match, and I'm in the shade W4. The coverage is amazing. The blendability is amazing. The match, like the color match, is awesome. And the next foundation is one that I started using maybe 4-5 months ago. But I love it, and this is the CoverGirl Outlast Stay Fabulous Foundation. This is the 3-in-1. I think it's like a primer, concealer, and foundation. This is amazing. I feel like it gives a pretty nice satin matte finish, and it lasts on the skin really, really well. I feel like it blends nicely. It's a really nice foundation. And then high-end is this Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation. Keeps you matte. And it's really good at like controlling your oils and not letting your oils move your makeup everywhere. I love the coverage. It is super, super like amazing full coverage. It stays in place all day. You really have to work to get this off at the end of the day. And for concealers, I have been loving my Maybelline Instant Age Rewind. This is in the shade Light. And it is just an amazing concealer. I'm wearing it today mixed in with another concealer that I'm going to show you guys. It's really good at brightening under the eyes. This does crease, so you definitely have to set it. But it has really good coverage, and it's really good at brightening. So it does what it says that it's supposed to do. So this is great. As you guys can tell, I love it because I've used up a lot of it. This is my second tube. And one that I fell in love with towards the ending of the summer is this Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. And this one's in the shade San Sable. It's the one that I use the most. The consistency is great. The coverage is great. Now for setting my under eyes or my face, my Rimmel Stay Matte. This has been loved by me dearly this year. It sets the makeup really nicely without making you look like cakey. And it sets the under eyes really nicely, and it leaves like a nice matte finish, but it doesn't like dull you out. It looks really, really nice. This has been another setting powder. It's fairly new to my collection, but I have been using it almost exclusively for my under eyes. But this is the Maybelline Fit Me powder, and this is in the shade Classic Ivory. Like, leaves your under eyes looking very bright and very luminous, and I love it. So definitely a must have for me. I'm gonna show you guys my favorite bronzer, and this is from Physicians Formula. It is the Bronze Booster in Medium to Dark, and this is just a beautiful overall bronzer. I love this. I use this consistently throughout the year. And then to contour, I have loved my NYC Smooth Skin Bronzing Face Powder, and this is in the shade Sunny. It can be a little bit orangey, depending on your complexion, but overall I feel like it contours really nice for like a light contour, and it blends out really nicely. And I also love that this is such a great crease shade for the eye, and super inexpensive. This is like $2, so definitely one that I recommend. Overall, throughout the year, these three have been like my babies, the ones that I have gravitated to the most, the ones that just complement pretty much every look. I just love them. This first one is from MAC, and this is in the shade Melba, and this is just like your safe blush, like the blush where you don't really have to think about it, and you just kind of put it on and it just looks good. So yeah, definitely one of my favorites. And then I have also loved this blush from NYX for a really long time. This is in the shade Terracotta. I just feel like this gives like a beautiful bronzy, glowy look to the skin. And these NYX blushes are really, really great. They're really pigmented. So I definitely, definitely have loved this so, so much. Especially in the summer. I think I use this blush almost every single day. It's awesome. This is Milani's Baked Powder Blush in the shade Luminoso. And this is a beautiful, like, peachy gold shade. It is so pretty on the skin. It just like warms up the cheeks so nicely, and it looks so beautiful. I think this is definitely a must for everyone's collection. You should definitely, definitely check this out. I love it. I'm wearing it today, and it's beautiful. Now for highlighters, I didn't really use those a lot before, so I can't say that I have been loving some for the whole year. I can't say that these next two products I'm going to show you have been my yearly favorites, but I do feel like they are honorable mentions because they're just amazing products that I feel like everyone should definitely try out. My first honorable mention, because it is already a favorite, but I can't count it as a yearly favorite, is my Becca highlight, and this is in the shade Opal. This is so beautiful. Everybody loves this highlight, and it's with like legit reason, because it just looks so beautiful on the skin. It's like, oh my god. I have no words to explain how beautiful this highlight is. If you have a Sephora or a Ulta near you, go and swatch this and then decide if you can live without this, because I couldn't. I recently purchased this Physicians Formula Shimmer Strip in Natural Nude, and all the type of different highlighting shades that you get is awesome. I love that each little block is a different color. When you swirl them all together, it creates this beautiful glow. Or you can just use them in like little strips or little boxes and just kind of custom create the highlight that you want for your face. So I feel like the $15 that you spent for it goes a really, really long way. My yearly favorite, which is my Mary Luminizer. This is beautiful. It is like a white goldy champagne type of highlight. It is so gorgeous. A little bit goes such a long way on the skin. Now for mascaras, I am a mascara lover, and this year I have fallen head over heels in love with four mascaras. This is the Jordana Best Lash Extreme. This is like a $3 mascara. It is so volumizing. It is like super black. I love this. I think it does a fairly good job at like lengthening as well. Definitely, if you do buy this, clean up the wand before you apply, because if not, it will get really, really clumpy. Besides that, I feel like this is one of the best mascaras I have ever used. It is great. And then my new love, I think I fell in love with this like maybe 2 or 3 months ago, has been my Telescopic Carbon Black Mascara. I generally don't go for lengthening mascaras, but I feel like for every day, this is just great. It like really elongates the lashes, and it really like separates them. They look so nice. And then my two high-end mascaras are these two little babies. This one is, of course, my Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. You guys know this is like my favorite mascara of all time. I love it, I love it, I love it. And this is just like an hourglass type of wand. I feel like it really hugs every lash, and it's just really good at volumizing and lengthening. It's perfect. It doesn't flake on me. It is beautiful. It always gives me like these full flirty lashes, and that's what I love. Definitely my favorite mascara of all time. And then for my lower lashes, I love my Clinique bottom lash mascara. This is so good. The wand is super duper tiny, so it's really easy to get into every single lash in the lower lashes and like volumize and lengthen them. I recently got into the whole liquid eyeliner thing, and this is my Jessie's Girl Cosmetics liquid eyeliner, and this is in black. This is just amazing. Definitely recommend it. It is super black. And then the more high-end version is my Lorac Front of the Line Pro Eyeliner in the shade black. This is amazing. This literally does not move. If you swatch this on your hand, let me show you. You swatch this and it is super duper intensely black. Now I'm going to talk about this and let this set, and then we're going to check it, okay? This is so, oh my god, I love it. It allows you to create such a nice precise line. It is so black. It is so perfect. I love this. It has such a fine tip. Honestly, they're awesome. I feel like the tip on this one is even finer than my Jessie's Girls. And it's just like, it just gives for more precision when you are applying your eyeliner. It is amazing. Definitely worth every penny. And I love it. Okay, so it dried. Look. If I go shower now, this won't come off. I literally have to use like makeup remover to get this off. It is insane how amazing this Lorac liquid eyeliner is. I love it. Before I started using liquid liners, I was more of a gel eyeliner kind of girl. I love my Maybelline Eye Studio gel liner in Black is Black. It is so creamy. I've made quite a dent on this. I don't know if you guys can tell, but it is super super creamy. It's so easy to work with. It is so matte. It lasts such a long time on the eyes. It is so beautiful. I love this gel liner so so much, and I definitely recommend it. And I think that it's only like $7, so definitely give this a try because it is awesome. For my waterline, I generally use a nude eyeliner. This has been the one that I have used the most, and this is my Rimmel Scandalous liner thing in nude. Hey guys, my favorite lip liner of the entire year, and this is my NYX lip liner in the shade Natural. This is just a perfect nude to me. I love the way it looks under any lipstick. It is so beautiful. And then I have a whole bunch of lip products because I love lipstick. I just love it. It's probably my first like makeup love, and then eyeshadows. So yeah, these are just my NYX butter glosses and my NYX soft matte lip creams. I just kind of have to show you guys all of them because I can't pick shades. My favorite lip glosses, I'm not really a lip gloss lover, but this is probably like my favorite lip gloss ever. And these are the NYX butter glosses. They are very like buttery on the skin. They do not feel sticky at all. The only thing with these is that they do not have a long lasting power, but still, for $5 a pop, I don't care. So I have these are some of my favorite shades, and this is in the shade Creme Brulee, and this is in the shade Apple Strudel, and they smell like a bakery. And then I love my NYX soft matte lip creams. These are so lightweight on the lips. They last a really really long time. As you guys know, matte is just my favorite finish on lipsticks, and I feel like this is such a beautiful lipstick. It leaves such a nice finish. Again, super lightweight, super easy to reapply, and they also smell like a bakery. It's just amazing. These are probably my top two shades. I'm wearing this one today, and this is in the shade Athens. I top that with Apple Strudel, and that's what I'm wearing on my lips. And then this is in the shade Transylvania. It's just a beautiful, like, super, super duper, like, black purple. It's perfect. I love it. And yeah, these are definitely a must-have for me this year. I have used them so much. I love my Wet n Wild lipstick, but specifically these three shades. These are $2. These are their Megalast lipsticks, and I'm just gonna show you guys my favorite shades of the year. This one's a fairly new shade for me, and it's called Rose to Fame, and it's just a beautiful like mauve rose pink, and these are my type of colors. I love it so much. And when I want to get a little bit more peachy, I've been using Just Peachy a lot throughout the year, especially more like in the summer. It's just a beautiful peach shade. These look so nice on the lips. They last such a long time, and they have such a nice like satin matte type of finish. They apply really creamy and then they just kind of dry like nice satiny. It's just, they're beautiful. But my favorite shade is definitely this one, and this is Embear It All. This is just like a brown peach nude. It is the perfect nude to me. Then these last two shades are from Maybelline's new creamy matte line. They are the creamiest mattes ever, but they really are matte, and they just apply so nicely to the lips. They're super lightweight. They don't like accentuate any fine lines or any chapped lips. It's just, they're amazing, amazing, amazing lipsticks. And I'll show you guys my two favorite shades. This is in the shade A Touch of Spice. And when I saw this, I just like fell in love. Now this shade is probably like the most beautiful deep like red wine shade. And this is in Divine Wine. It is so stunning. It is such a beautiful lipstick. And I feel like definitely for fall and winter, this is definitely a must have and should be a staple in your collection. So buy it. For my high end products, I have fallen in love with Stila Stay All Day Liquid Lipsticks. My love affair started with this little baby right here, and this is in the shade Beso, and it is such a beautiful, vibrant, like in your face red. It is stunning. I still have a little sample, but I will definitely repurchase the full size once I finish this shade. And once I fell in love with the formula of that, because they're very lightweight on the lips, they do feel a little bit tacky, but again, they are super long lasting, so I feel like that's a little bit expected. They don't really transfer once they set on the lips. They are amazing. And I purchased three more. And this is in the shade Fiery, and it's just a deeper, more like subtle red, if red could ever be subtle. But it is beautiful. And then I also purchased this shade Aria, and this is actually the lipstick that I was wearing in my New Year's Eve makeup tutorial. I'll link it down below so you guys can see how beautiful this lipstick is. It is so stunning. It's just like a raspberry kind of purple, and it's, oh, I love it. But probably my favorite shade from all of them, as much as I love reds, has been this one, and this is in the shade Patina. This took me forever to find because it was sold out for the longest. And then once I got it, I just fell completely in love. This is just, again, my rosy, mauve-y type of pinky nudes. It is so beautiful. These next two lipsticks are very expensive, but they are very, very much worth the money because they are so amazing. And I'm talking about the NARS Audacious lipsticks. These are $32 a pop. I never thought that I would spend so much money on a lipstick, but once I tried one, I was like, oh my god, this is amazing. The pigmentation of this lipstick is beyond like my comprehension. It is so amazing. They don't smell like anything. They last so long on the lips. They feel so nice on the lips. I feel like these are the type of lipsticks that make your lips look perfect. Like, they just make them look better. They do not like sink into any fine lines. They don't accentuate anything. Any chappedness on your, nothing. It's just like creamy heaven on your lips. It is amazing. They apply really creamy and then they dry, not matte or anything. Very just like satiny and just very beautiful, and I love them. My two favorite shades are Anna, which again, you guys can see the trend with like my types of nudes. But this is just a beautiful, beautiful like rosy mauve-y. It's just so stunning. I love it. And you guys can see like one swipe is just crazy, crazy pigmentation. And then the next one is Charlotte. This is definitely like, oh my god, look. It's just crazy how pigmented these lipsticks are. I know it's crazy to spend so much money on a lipstick, but if you are a lipstick obsessed junkie, like you love lipsticks, you definitely need to try these out because these are amazing lipsticks. I want them all, but I can't afford them. I want to buy a few more, but later because yeah, they're expensive. Probably like the biggest thing to come out in the drugstore when it comes to eyeshadows were these Milani eyeshadows. These two are my favorite transition shades. This is in the shade Bella Cafe, and this is in Bella Mandarin. And these are just beautiful, beautiful transition shades. I'm actually wearing these two today in my crease, and I love them. And these three are my favorite, like, shimmery shades. They're just beautiful. This is in the shade Bella Copper, and this is what I have on my eyelids today. I have a lot of fallout with these metallic ones if I don't use Fix Plus. But when you do use Fix Plus, they are beautiful. This next one is the Shimmer, and it's in Bella Khaki. And I have this one on my lower lash line. This one is pretty pigmented on its own, and I really, really like the color. It's like a green gold, and it's beautiful, beautiful. And then this is the one that I just fell in love with because it reminds me of a mermaid. And this one is called Bella Teal, and it's also a metallic. Again, definitely one that looks better once it is wet, but they are beautiful shades. And if you are just curious to try them, I feel like those are probably my top shades where you can really work with them and get pretty good like pigmentation. So yeah, they're really good. That along with this Sonia Kashuk palette is all that I have on my eyes today. This is my Sonia Kashuk Ion Neutral Matte Palette. This I have had for a little over a year, and I love it so much. It is such a beautiful matte palette, especially from the drugstore, because I feel like it's really difficult to find good matte products at the drugstore. It's $20. I got my Sonia Kashuk at Target. I think it's exclusive to Target. It's a little expensive, but it's a really good palette. They can get a little powdery, but I love them. So yeah, definitely one of my favorites for the year. I feel like this year has been the year that I have fallen head over heels in love with Makeup Geek. I feel like Makeup Geek is such an awesome brand. Their products are so amazing and they're so inexpensive. And I just wanted to share with you guys like all my Makeup Geek eyeshadows. This brown right here and these three rows up are all my Makeup Geek product. I absolutely love these eyeshadows. They are so amazing. They are so insanely pigmented, and I have been loving these all year. And then I have to give these babies an honorable mention, and these are my Makeup Geek foiled eyeshadows. These just came out like less than a month ago, but they are so amazing. They are so insanely pigmented. They are so perfect. And they're like $10, and the pigmentation is insane. Like, it's just absolutely insane. Now, these last two products are probably my favorite palettes, and I have quite a few palettes. The first one is my Urban Decay Naked palette. You can create so many beautiful looks with this, and I just feel like the pigmentation is beautiful. Like, the colors are gorgeous. Like, absolutely, absolely gorgeous. Let's see, I'll swatch that right there. Look at that. They're just super buttery. They have two good transition shades and like two good highlight shades. Can you guys see how beautifully pigmented that is? Oh my god, it's one of my favorite shades. And then I definitely, definitely have to mention my Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette. I love this palette. I purchased this palette, I think, in August. When this palette first came out, I wasn't sure if I was gonna buy it. I felt like I had a lot of neutral shades already, but I eventually just gave in. I was like, this is so beautiful, I have to try it out. And I just purchased it. It's perfect. It smells delicious. I love the different types of pops of color, and it has a nice variety of mattes. Like I said, my only problem with my Naked palette is that it lacks a little bit of mattes, and it lacks like a nice pop of color. And I feel like with this palette, you like get everything, and you have such a good size highlight, matte, and shimmer. Probably one of my favorite palettes of all time. I reach for this constantly. Every time, I swear, every single time that I use this palette, I am wowed again. Like, I fall in love with it every single time. The names of the eyeshadows are not like on or anywhere near the eyeshadows. It just comes with like a little plastic insert, and a lot of people complained about that. So much so that the new palette actually has the names. If you have this palette and if you still have your insert, what I did was that I don't want to blind you guys. I just grabbed the insert and then I taped it to the inside of my palette. I hope that's helpful to anybody, but yeah. So yeah, guys, that does it for my favorites for the year 2014. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys did a best of 2014 beauties or whatever, link it down below because I would love to see it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't, and I will see you guys in my next video.